Welcome back to Building Character, where we figure out how to play as your favorite fictional characters in Dungeons & Dragons. Join the Patreon to vote for Kaiba from Yu-Gi-Oh! Or L from Death Note, and like and subscribe for more solar power next time you play. Maybe. Today we're building Tien, one of my favorite Dragon Ball characters, even if he doesn't get to ascend to the godly levels of Goku and Vegeta. But if I've learned anything while building Dragon Ball Z characters in Dungeons & Dragons, it's that sometimes making a character that's totally busted and can do a billion different things isn't the best idea. Maybe we just need to keep our eye on a few abilities, or a few eyes on a few abilities. Let's start off with our goals for this build. First, we need some martial arts abilities. Punching, kicking, not wearing shirts, the bread and butter of the original series. Next, we need the power of the sun in the palm of our hand, with a solar flare to surprise people, with flashing. Finally, we need that pyramid power, with a triangular blast that could even blow up Cell. Tien kind of roasts Cell. It doesn't stick, but it's cool as heck, and I just think the humans should get some sort of power upgrade to be relevant and super. Anyway, for stats, we're using the standard point array from the player's handbook, or for stats, if you want, just keep your multiclassing minimums in mind. Dexterity will be number one, you are a traditional martial artist, and while you are super strong like the other Z fighters, you're not picking up mountains like they do. Wisdom next, obviously your perception is high, you have an extra eye, bars. Constitution after that, remember when I said people are throwing mountains? Those people punch you sometimes. Follow that up with strength, helping you feel like a strong guy, because your athletic score will push it up higher. Charisma is a bit low, you're friends with Chiaotzu, but that's about it, and he's like a permanent child bound boy who's psychic and can explode. Maybe I should build Chiaotzu, he sounds wild. We'll dump intelligence when you spend your whole life training to fight, you lose out on the book smarts, and you take a few bumps to the noggin. Tien is a human that has a third eye from some dormant Tri-Clops alien DNA, so custom lineage. That'll let you grab a feat, like athlete. To add one to your dexterity, you can jump with 5 feet of run up instead of 10, stand up from prone with 5 feet of movement instead of half, and you get a climbing speed equal to your normal speed. The extra dexterity is the best part, but you know I'll never turn down mobility options. Bump your dexterity even higher with your 2 free points, take perception for your skill of choice, and build your own background for persuasion and medicine skills. Obviously, we need athletics and acrobatics, but we can get those from the starting class. That starting class is Monk, by the way, where you can grab athletics and acrobatics. Kind of telegraphed that one. You also get martial arts, letting you make unarmed attacks that deal 1d4 damage using your dexterity modifier, and you can make another one as a bonus action after you make one with your action for a rapid fire combo at level 1. Now, you can't be wearing armor, but Tien rocks a bare chest all the time, so use unarmored defense to make your AC 10 plus your dexterity and wisdom modifier when you're not wearing armor. Second level Monks get key points you can use to do cool three-eyed guy stuff like Step of the Wind, letting you dash or disengage as a bonus action with a double jump distance. Pairs pretty well with the athlete feat, since you can jump faster. Patient Defense lets you dodge as a bonus action, getting your guard up to avoid more hits from super gods. Flurry of Blows lets you make 2 unarmed attacks instead of 1 with a bonus action for a 3-hit combo at level 2. Maybe this is a bunch of punches, maybe this is 2 extra arms coming out of your back to hit people more. Who knows? There's also Unarmored Movement, making you faster when you're not wearing armor. It's kind of hard to keep up with Z fighters if you don't have Monk speed. Third level Monks can choose a monastic tradition. 4 elements Monks will give us the stuff we need from elemental disciplines. Fist of Unbroken Air will let you spend up to 2 key points to make a creature within 30 feet of you make a strength saving throw, dealing 3d10 bludgeoning damage and pushing them 20 feet or knocking them prone if they fail. Half damage and no moving if they succeed. Before you shoot your lasers, you need to shoot some air. You can also deflect missiles, letting you reduce damage of incoming ranged attacks by 1d10 plus your dexterity and Monk level as a reaction. If you drop it to 0, you can even throw it back with a key point. Not like a member of the Z Fighters is gonna get taken out by a gun, just like a regular gun. Fourth level Monks get Slow Fall, letting you reduce falling damage by 5 times your Monk level as a reaction, which is gonna be pretty important once we get a flying speed. If we get a flying speed. No spoilers. You also get an Ability Score Improvement, letting you cap off your Dexterity modifier super fast. Custom Lineage is wonderful, and it'll get you ready to win tournaments, before the Z gets added to the show name at least. Fifth level Monks get an extra attack, letting you make 2 attacks instead of 1, or up to 4 with a Flurry of Blows. You're definitely gonna need 4 arms for that, like the number 4, not like the front part of your arm, and not for like a d4, because your Monk die is now a d6. You also get Stunning Strike, letting you force a constitution saving throw on a creature you hit with a melee weapon attack. Failing that, they're stunned until the end of your next turn. I'm not reflavoring that to be Solar Flare, that's just Tien hitting pretty hard. For your Solar Flare, we're gonna go over to Cleric, specifically a Light Domain Cleric. That'll give you a Warding Flare, letting you impose disadvantage on someone attacking you as a reaction, an amount of times per long rest equal to your wisdom modifier, blinding foes that try to harm the hairs on your head, or that the skin on your shoulder. You also get the light cantrip for free, helping you see in the dark with your three bad custom lineage eyes and other cantrips and spells as well. Sacred Flame is a nice Dodon Ray, forcing a dexterity saving throw on a creature and dealing 2d8 radiant damage to them if they fail. You can ignore cover to steer that beam around a corner if you want. Word of Radiance will surround you in light, forcing a constitution saving throw on creatures within 5 feet of you, dealing 2d6 radiant damage to those that fail, encouraging the Cybermen to leave you alone. Guidance and Resistance give a creature a d4 to add to ability checks or saving throws respectively, just making you better than most humans, because you're kind of an alien, kind of. For your first level spells, Light Domain Clerics get Fairy Fire for free, forcing a dexterity saving throw on creatures in a 20-foot cube. Failing that, creatures have advantage on attacks against them for up to a minute, depending on your concentration. Warding Flare is the defensive solar flare. Fairy Fire is the offensive solar flare. Guiding Bolt lets you make a ranged spell attack that deals 4d6 radiant damage and gives the next target attacking that creature advantage on the roll, so they might try as well to throw a beam. Call it a tri-beam. This is the tri-beam. Cure Wounds is a nice Sensu beam, giving a creature you touch a d8 plus your wisdom modifier in healing. Bless just sort of makes your friends better, letting up to 3 of them add a d4 to attack rolls and saving throws for up to a minute, depending on your concentration. That means Tien, Yamcha, and Yajirobe will be ready to take on Jiren. Maybe. Probably not. Finally, Shield of Faith adds 2 to a creature's AC for up to 10 minutes, if you just want to be a little bit harder to hit. Second level clerics can channel divinity. All of them can turn undead, scaring undead that fail a wisdom saving throw and forcing them to dash away with their action. But generally, I like using the ones from your domain, and light clerics get Radiance of the Dawn, filling a 30-foot radius around you with light that dispels darkness and forces a constitution saving throw on creatures in the area, dealing 2d10 plus your cleric level in radiant damage to them if they fail, half damage on a success. Since you can only use this once per short rest, it's obviously tiring you out a little bit. Maybe that's a better option for the tri-beam. Third level clerics can learn second level spells like blindness, deafness, forcing a constitution saving throw on a creature. Failing that, they're blinded or deafened for a minute or until they can make the save. Blindness is obviously the solar flare version, but if deafness seems more useful, I think that's fair. Enhance ability gives a creature advantage on ability checks of a certain type. If you choose strength, their carrying capacity is also doubled. If you choose dexterity, they don't take falling damage from heights of 20 feet or less, and constitution gives them 2d6 temporary HP. Pairing it with athletics is a great way to get an hour of super strength, even if you don't have the ability score flexibility for super strength. Fourth level clerics get another ability score improvement. We'll start investing in wisdom now. That'll be better saves on your cleric spells and elemental attunements, more AC, and more warding flares. It's a lot of good stuff. Let's jump back over to monk now for more good stuff. Sixth level monks get key empowered strikes, making your unarmed attacks magical in terms of overcoming resistances. Now you can punch aliens and robots without worrying whether or not they're immune. You can also grab another elemental attunement. Fist of the Four Thunders lets you cast the Thunder Wave spell with 2 key points, forcing a constitution saving throw on creatures in a 15-foot cube in front of you, dealing 2d8 thunder damage to those that fail, and pushing the max 10 feet, half damage, and no pushing if they succeed. You can even upcast it by spending an additional key point, which is actually a more economical form of upcasting than with a spellcaster, since key points are inherently less valuable, other than on Flurry of Blows and Stunning Strike, which are actually rad. It's so weird that people think monks are bad. 7th level monks get evasion, letting you take half damage on failed dexterity saving throws and no damage on successful ones. Lots of Z fighters use Sacred Flame for a standard key blast, so this will already make that less effective on our boy Tien. Stillness of Mind lets you remove an effect of Charming or Frightening, which is good when you're a little outclassed by some of the villains. Maybe it's bad, actually. Running away would probably be a good idea. 8th level monks get another ability score improvement. Keep working on your wisdom modifier, since it's just so gosh dang good to invest it. It'll give you brighter lights. 9th level monks get unarmored movement improvement, letting you move up walls and over water without falling in, as long as you're not wearing armor. This is going to be a little less useful once we get a flying speed, obviously, but for now it's pretty good. Especially because we don't get a flying speed at 10th level monk, you just get purity of body for immunity to poison and disease, including poison damage. That's only in the game though. If you want to keep your family and friends safer from disease, get vaccinated. It's the best bet. 11th level 4 elements monks can ride the wind, an elemental attunement that lets you cast the fly spell with 4 key points. That gives you a 60-foot flying speed, except actually, hold up, because you have unarmored movement and you get an extra 20 feet, that's 80 feet of flying speed. It makes the 4 elements version of fly a little bit better than the others, because 4 elements isn't actually all that bad. They get some very good attunements that work really well with monk. They're kind of expensive on key points, but that's fine. Your martial arts die also bumps up to a d8 here. 12th level monks get another ability score improvement, so you can cap off your wisdom modifier to maximize your lasers before we bounce back to the laser class. 5th level clerics can learn 3rd level spells. You get 2 for free from the light domain, like daylight, dispelling darkness and creating a ball of light with a 60-foot radius of bright light, and 60 feet further of that with dim light for an hour. No concentration required. It's great to make caves a little more easy to explore. Fireball forces a dexterity saving throw on creatures in a 20-foot radius, dealing 8d6 fire damage to those that fail, half as much to those that succeed if you want a bigger energy blast that deals fire damage instead of radiant. Spirit Shroud is a fantastic spell to have on a monk, adding a d8 of radiant, necrotic, or cold damage to the attacks you make within 10 feet of you and stopping the creatures you hit from healing. Their speed is also reduced by 10 feet, lasts for a minute depending on your concentration, and will make each punch deal 2d8 damage, getting a little bit of your ki blasts into your fist blasts. Finally, Sanding lets you send a message to another creature on the same plane as you and even to other planes with a 5% failure rate in case you need to call Goku for some backup. 6th level clerics get improved Warding Flare, letting you use your Warding Flare when an ally within 30 feet of you is attacked as well, to protect Widow Chaozu and his 100-year-old baby face. You also get another use of Channel Divinity per day, so you can pop 2 dawns per short rest. Now, I was going to do the standard 12-8 multi-class split, but then I realized the 4th level spells aren't really anything I want, and I just use ability score improvements on Resilient for Constitution. But you know what's better? Just continuing into Monk. 13th level monks get Tongue of the Sun and Moon, letting you communicate with every creature that speaks at least one language. Obviously, you understand Nappa when he lands, you understand that he sucks. Our capstone is the 14th level of monk for Diamond Soul, giving you proficiency with all saving throws. Now, you don't have to worry about dropping concentration, getting feeble-minded, charmed, or banished. Well, you don't have to worry about it as much. Now that we've hit level 20, let's figure out how viable this build is. First, you're hard to put damage on with 20 base AC and proficiency with all saving throws. You can even buff your AC with Shield of Faith or saving throws with Bless, or use Patient Defense to dodge or Warding Flare to give your enemy attacks disadvantage. You can also deal very consistent damage with a standard 3-hit combo that has a d8 damage die, up to 4 per round, and the ability to double that with Spirit Shroud. Finally, you can fly, and you fly faster than most flying creatures thanks to unarmored movement. For weaknesses, low intelligence means that you might not always be in the loop for the lore. Just ask people to explain it if you missed an entire season. You also have a couple of different concentration spells, and you can only have one up at a time. Finally, after you use Fly with Elemental Attunement, you only have 10 key points left that short rest. So hot idea, don't use Fly if you don't need to fly. Just run around fast, shoot lasers, and flash your enemies to keep yourself and the team safe. Just watch out for more unusual foes. They could give you some boo-boos. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, subscribe for more. We make 2 videos every week. Join the Patreon to vote for Kaiba from Yu-Gi-Oh! Or L from Death Note, and sub to Tulok and Mango for more Tulok fun.